Well, I want to say what an honor it is to be with this distinguished group of people. And my job here is to briefly open up very big questions, like capitalism versus socialism, things like that.
You have four minutes for that question.
I want to point out that something wasn't sufficiently noticed is that 2008, which was the year of the global financial meltdown, was also the 160th anniversary of the Communist Manifesto's publication. And who knew that the capitalists were going to celebrate that anniversary by shooting themselves? It's always folly to say this is the end of capitalism. Capitalism is, you have to admire it. It's so dynamic. It's so resilient. You know, you push it down, it comes back. It's terrific in that way. And we all know the joke about the Marxist economist who correctly predicted 11 out of the last three recessions. You know, so I'm very cautious about it. But it's just, for now, capitalism is not working. It's not working anymore. And, you know, that's why there's suddenly talk of socialism. Suddenly, Obama is being tarred as a socialist. And I say with great respect for the man, and not wishing to hurt its feelings or anything, but Barack Obama is not a socialist, all right? You know, at the very least, what we have to shake off at this moment is the curious religion, and I call it a religion, that Americans have been in the grip of for years, and that is market fundamentalism. The market as a deity that will take care of everything for us so that we can, you know, eventually all the deserving poor will be wealthy according to market fundamentalism. Of course, eventually everything will be okay. Now that has had the quality of a religious belief in this country without, of course, evidence. But instead of promoting self-reliance as it was advertised to, I think it has fostered a kind of collective passivity in our culture, that you don't really have to worry about so many injustices and so many forms of human misery, because eventually the invisible hand will come down and smooth all brows and everything. Now, you know, see, if that doesn't work, then it seems to me very simply that the alternative to that religious delusion of market fundamentalism is to determine our own destiny as human beings, to realize that there's not something called the market that's going to do it for us. And I'd say that is the essence to me of what the socialist legacy is. It's this idea, very simple idea, that people can get together and figure out solutions to problems together. You know, that you're not waiting for something else to do it for you. That's really, you know, what seems to me so resoundingly inspiring about 19th century socialism and what it leaves to us. But we have a much harder situation than they faced, I think, in the mid-19th century, say, European workers' movements. You know, they thought at that time that industrial capitalism had done this great thing that had potentially eliminated scarcity from the world. You know, because you can make all the stuff. And the only thing that socialists had to do was take over those means of production and make sure that the stuff got distributed in a better way so that everybody had enough. That was the project of socialism. Now, 160 years later, we can no longer sit back and applaud capitalism for producing unlimited plenty and abundance. In fact, when we look at the world, we have to come to the very sad realization that we are left by capitalism with less than what we started with in many ways. That the environmental damage, not only of industrial capitalism, but of industrial communism too, I should say, you know, has left us so depleted of so many resources and in danger on so many fronts that I don't think it is crazy or paranoid to say that our species faces a threat of extinction as a possibility. So I'm just going to wind up by saying, leaving you with that, no, is that it's not simply a matter of changing ownership, so the people own the means of production or something like that. It is a matter of rethinking what we mean by production and our entire way of life.